I have Nancy Cohen with me. She's the author of Delirium, The Politics of Sex in America. Nancy, this is more than just Todd Akin's war on women. This is a party war on women. And it's not just about women. I mean, my God, how do you get your arms around the dumbed down nature of what this party's become?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is the Republican Party, unzipped and unscripted. You know, Romney went to the same science school that Akin did. You know, Akin says that a woman has some magical substance in our bodies that will prevent, you know, a rape that we didn't ask for or something. Well, Romney is opposed to the morning after pill. He calls it an abortive pill, mm-hmm. right? That's scientifically, medically false. Now, the point is, the Republican Party, you know, all the establishment, the super PACs, they're desperately trying to get Akin to drop out of the race today. But, you know, as you said earlier, it doesn't matter if he drops out of the race, because this is the Republican Party position. No abortion, no exceptions, not even for rape, incest, or the life of the mother.
Yeah, Nancy, you know, I see the national GOP's pulled fund. They say that they're pulling funding out for Todd Akin's Missouri race. But the point that you've made so long, I mean, you have been on the front line on this. I've interviewed you before the very topic, and that is, this flows from the top. You know, all Akin is a symptom. You see, it's the symptom of the gray-haired old white guys that are dead or dying, that now literally own the party. And so all he is a symptom. So it's not, as you point out, it's about Romney. It's about Ryan. This is something that you don't get rid of simply by getting rid of one toadstool like Todd Akin.
Right, right. I mean, the extremists are running the show from the top to the bottom, from the bottom to the top. You know, so Romney came out and has this kind of vague repudiation of Akin's comment about the rape comment, and used some lawyerly language to say that they don't oppose abortion in the cases of rape. Well, you know, Romney, it's time to put up or shut up. If you truly think that women who are raped should have legal access to abortion, show you mean it in clear, unambiguous language. Tell the Republican platform committee that is meeting this week and that will adopt the platform next week when you are officially nominated, that they need to include exceptions for rape, incest, and the life of the mother. And you know what? He won't say it, and it won't happen, because other presidential candidates have been trying to get this change for years, and they've all been knocked down by the extremists, the religious fanatics who control the Republican Party.
How will he let the little Leave It to Beaver, how is he going to respond to all this? What's he going to let Ryan say?
Oh, I guess, you know, Ryan will be the lapdog following him around, the sixth son. So Ryan really has to be quiet, because Ryan has the exact voting record that Akin does. Together, they've co-sponsored bills to change the definition of rape. Ryan has insinuated that women who have abortions, even women who are raped who have abortions, should be prosecuted under the law when he achieves his goal of criminalizing abortion again.
You
Ryan,
understand.
Ryan said, I'm as pro-life as a person gets. You're not going to have a truce. They want judges that will overturn Roe v. Wade, overturn Griswold v. Connecticut, and allow them to make abortion illegal and even potentially to make birth control illegal.
Well, I mean, with Ryan, where we are is, we know he's put it down in paper, black and white. We've seen where he and Akin, you understand, had that idea gone any further, before a woman could get an abortion, there would have had to have been a finding of fact by a judge, possibly even a jury, as to whether or not she was forcibly raped or whether it was legitimate rape. How are we even talking about something like forcible or legitimate rape? How is that even coming to the vernacular of this Republican Party? I mean, have they? Look, is that the new phase?
This is the result of what I talk about in my book, Delirium. This is 40 years of sexual counter-revolution, where the Republican Party was taken over by religious fanatics whose main goal is to turn back the gains and rights for women and gays. And you know what? They don't like they don't like to provide money to support domestic violence victims either. They want to go back to a time when there was no marital rape laws on the books, when a married woman couldn't accuse her husband of rape. You know, they're so antediluvian. It's just
well, you know what? The thing that I get emails about and calls about and Twitters about is the fact of there's always this notion of this Republican mentality that, I mean, we saw it with Vitter. I mean, Vitter in Louisiana, who's like the number one name on the madam's list in, in D.C., or whether it's Craig, you know, whatever it is, you see these odd stories that are some type of odd sexual subplot, you know, to all of these voices who were always out there out front saying, I know morality. You know, Ted Haggard, great example. You know, Haggard had 30 million right-wing Southern Baptist evangelicals that were his folks. And, you know, then we find out he was in a hotel room with a male prostitute snorting God knows what else. So it comes down to this. It comes down to the idea that at least be honest with them. They need to be honest about who they really are, and they maybe own up to the fact they got some real problems way, way upstairs. Nancy, we're short on time. I'm sorry. I really appreciate it. By the way, great book. Delirium is a great book. Everybody be reading that. Should be reading that book.
You're listening to the Tom Hartman Program.